Modern military vehicles, both aircraft and ground machines, are equipped with a variety of defensive aid systems. Some warn the crew about threats, while others also react to them, deploying countermeasures automatically. Today, we'd like to make a short review of defensive aid systems implemented in War Thunder. As early as the dawn of the jet era, combat aircraft began to receive the first radar warning receivers, or RWR for short. Their purpose is to alert crews when enemy radars are active, indicating possible detection. These systems are fairly simple. Radar emissions are picked up by external sensors, which are essentially small antennas. The signals are then processed by an onboard computer, which analyzes the data. The computer can infer a lot of important information, including the direction and strength of the waves, as well as the radar's frequency and active mode, while the most advanced systems can even tell the exact model of the vehicle. To enable this, information about potential adversaries is preloaded into the system's database by the manufacturer. Finally, the result of the analysis is presented to the crew via dedicated indicators, multifunctional displays, or even voice alerts. Naturally, this process only takes the computer a fraction of a second. Some warning systems are set up to detect infrared waves instead of radio. Both in real life and in-game, such sensors are installed on many tanks and helicopters, as well as on certain model aircraft. They operate on a similar principle. Detectors arranged around the vehicle register laser illumination. Depending on their design, these detectors may only signal that a laser is active, or they may also indicate the direction to its source. Warning systems of various types quickly evolved from detecting the presence of a threat to identifying its type. The next logical step was active counteraction. Some ground vehicles are equipped with electro-optical countermeasures, a type of APS. These are essentially lamps that emit in the near-infrared spectrum invisible to the human eye. For ATGM trackers, however, this light is extremely bright. When an infrared emitter enters their field of view, it causes interference in the missile's guidance system. As a result, the missile receives incorrect control commands and misses its target. Similar systems exist on aircraft where they are usually referred to as infrared countermeasures, or IRCMs. These are also infrared emitters, but instead of confusing ground-based trackers, they deceive the seekers of IR-guided air-to-air missiles. Their emission disrupts guidance, causing the ordnance to lose lock on the real target. More recently, War Thunder has introduced directed infrared countermeasures. Unlike traditional lamps, these systems blind missile seekers with a focused laser beam. Another type of defensive aids we'd like to discuss in this video is active protection systems, or APS. These systems destroy incoming projectiles before they strike the protected vehicle. First, miniature radars detect a projectile in flight, much like how standard radars track aerial targets. Then, specialized counter munitions are launched. They may come in different forms, from cylindrical grenades to flat plates. Onboard electronics calculate which counter munition to fire and in which sector to intercept the threat. Over time, APS technology has advanced significantly. Early models had narrow protection angles and long reaction times. Worst of all, they could only stop relatively slow projectiles. Modern systems, however, can intercept even high-velocity, fin-stabilized sabot rounds. Active defense systems aren't limited to ground vehicles. Aircraft have them as well. Naturally, nothing explodes near the delicate fuselages of planes and helicopters. Instead, the active nature of airborne systems lies in their automatic deployment of countermeasures. The combination of all defensive systems on an aircraft is known as Defensive Aids Suite, or DAS. Specialized sensors mounted around the airframe detect missile launches by spotting engine exhaust plumes or flashes in the infrared and ultraviolet spectrum. Once a launch is detected, the DAS warns the pilot and automatically dispenses countermeasures. On particularly advanced aircraft, the system can even decide on its own if it should release flares or chaff. Did you know how diverse defensive systems are, both in reality and in War Thunder? Share your thoughts in the comments. See you soon!